You came back and you came back from enlisting in the Army and decided that there needed to be more choices for scholarships for people like you, white men. Why?
Well, Christine, it really was just us looking at scholarships in America and groups that are trying to help their own and groups that are trying to help specific subsets of the population. Well, one of those subsets of the population was getting left out, and that was the Caucasian American male who wanted to go to college but maybe didn't have a bunch of money sitting around just because he was white and was male. And those are the people that we're trying to help.
Now, you get it. You get why there's so many scholarships for other groups, though, because for so long, it was just white men who were getting into school. And I'm talking until the last 30 years or so. So you're seeing that things have switched around a little bit, that where scholarships were meant to get people into college who never had the access before, demographic groups who never had the access before. You're saying now in Texas and in other states, quite frankly, the majority is becoming the minority. And for younger kids, especially when you look in Texas and some other states too, that they need to have a little bit of help now getting to college.
Well, unfortunately, Christine, I wasn't around 30 years ago to know what kind of people were going to school. All I know is what I've seen and what the rest of my board members have seen for our nonprofit organization, and that's all different kinds of people are going to school. And it just so happens that that those few people out there that just have money laying around, they are truly the minority. The majority is that people can't really afford college. People were working 40 hours a week, 50 hours a week, going to school full-time, and still having to borrow money. Mm-hmm. Education is expensive. I understand that.
Know.
And we found a group that has not been targeted yet by an ethnically-based scholarship, and we're here to help those people.
What are the other prerequisites for this scholarship?
The prerequisites are you need to substantiate financial need, prove that you are a member of your an active member in your community, mm-hmm. Demonstrate leadership potential, and also show us that you have a dedication to your education with high grades, and that's about it. Also, be 25% Caucasian American and male.
How much are the scholarships? What, $500 or so, right? And you're getting the money from donations. Are you concerned at all about getting money from, you know, there are some people, quite frankly, who are going to see this and think that, for example, white supremacist groups and people who might not share your politics, quite frankly, who might think that this is something that they want to support. Would you take money from them?
One of the very first things that we realized when bringing this organization together was this is a very abrasive subject in America. And one of the first things that we wrote on our website, we wanted to state clearly that we do not promote any kind of racial bigotry mm-hmm. or white supremacy, and we don't take money from people who do. If you're part of a white supremacist group keep your money. We don't want your money. That's our stance on that. We don't have any political agendas or any kind of message that we're trying to send. I've had dozens of questions about affirmative action. We're not saying anything about anything except for helping poor white males who are trying to go to college and need a little help.
Well, you know, we're told that in this economy that everyone, you know, needs to have the right kind of science and math-based, you know, education to get a job in a globalized economy. And you're right that a lot of people, you know, people are graduating from school with record debt. So scholarships, you know, we need them. We definitely need them. But you can see how some people might look at it and say, after men having the preferential treatment for so long, it makes them a little nervous, you know? Do you understand how some people might be nervous by it?
I can't say that I understand why people would be nervous about it. It's really about just broadening your horizons and looking at the entire scope of the population. If we're going to offer scholarships to group 1, 2, 3, and 4, but group 5 isn't allowed to have scholarships, that's
right.
A logical fallacy. White males, just because they're white and they're male, don't have a bunch of money sitting around ready to pay for $40,000, $50,000 tuitions. And so, you know, it's the pink elephant in the room. We're addressing that situation. Hey, it's time. Things have changed in our country, and this part of the population deserves help, and now, thanks to us, is going to get help.